Holman or something. Not Holman.
I haven't looked at that part close enough. Yeah. I've only looked at it in a general kind of way. Mm-hmm. Where it goes down through Skagit. And, yeah, it kind of skirts the south part of Baker and then out into the...
I did this trip when I was 19 from... From up by Mount Baker, and it ended at Beaver Creek on Ross Lake.
Yeah, that's it. That's the route.
That route. What's it? There's a path that starts with an H. Is it Hannigan? Maybe Hannigan?
Yeah, I think so. Because that's the.
No, not Hannigan. It's, I feel like it starts with an H. Holman is in the Pacific.
No,
it's not Holman.
Yeah.
I didn't do that whole route they're talking about. I just did like a 6-day trip or something from somewhere.
Yeah, but that's part of that. I mean, that's one of the most remote.
Oh, yeah, it's amazing.
You know the PNT?
Well, I've done the Poseidon part of it.
Yeah.
So I've never done that part, really. Yeah. The Poseidon part is awesome, where it goes along the border. It's incredible, really.
Yeah, I think it's, my understanding is that it's a pretty buried trail as far as, you know, all the, not only the different ecosystems it goes through, but like the different trails that it uses to piece together the whole scenic trail.
Right.
So yeah, you get some serious wilderness zones, and then like you're going through Puget Sound and
yeah.
on the ferry across the Port Townsend.
Well, see, I'd be confused where it goes from. Yeah, once the Poseidon is done, though, then all the way to Idaho is not. Oh, that's a wilderness or anything.
Yeah,
you know,
right.
Like
yeah, it goes through like, you know, the Kettle Country and
yeah.
stays north pretty much. Yeah. Yeah, totally. Yeah, and it's supposedly, though, just in general, the trail is, it's way more of a navigational challenge than the PCT.
Yeah.
Way more like navigating and route finding and, you know, some pretty
the
remote
PCT
wilderness
isn't
place.
Any route finding.
No, it's like a walking
highway.
On a road. Yeah.